Hi friends, how are you? So this is a continuation of Ask and Get to Know Me. So let's begin. So the next one is Tanushree Bhargava. She wants to know, is or was your twin equally spiritually inclined when you met them in the physical world? So let me tell you, no two twins are equally spiritually inclined. One will always be a little bit further or a little bit backwards than the other. There might also be cases that one person is very much backwards and the other person is quite aware of something like that. In my case also, it was not the case. Equality was not the case. Like I said, equality never is the case. That is the whole purpose of this journey. Ascension of both of them, but the rates of either are never the same, you know. That is why we have delays and we have, you know, when you feel you are ready, you know, when you think you are ready, but still you are not. In my case, also it was not the case. We were not equally spiritually inclined. My masculine twin or my twin flame was more towards the airy personality and I was more towards the watery side, meaning he was more mentally evaluating and I was more to the emotional side and more spiritually aware. And like I said in my previous videos, I was a spiritual master from 2006, but I was not doing twin flames specifically. I was doing all other kinds of things spiritually, you know. So yeah, definitely I would say much forward in the spiritual sense, but he was much forward in the practical sense, in living in this world in general, you know. So thank you so much. So Lavinia Nitoy, so hi, how much time did you and him actually spend living together? So, like I said, we met in the form of a relationship when we started dating. So, we spent a considerable time living together, equal time living together as we spent. So, it was around 2 years that we spent living together. And it was around, my separation was around 1 year, 8 months or around 2 years also. The first one when I came into union. After which I came into union. So my separation, for all of you, this is also a very important part that you should know. My separation was a clean cut separation. My separation was not that 2 months we were together and 2 months we were not talking, then 2 weeks we were together. My separation was around 1.5 year together and then total 1 year 8 months of no, you know, contact and living in the same city. No contact, no communication, nothing, clean cut. That is why I got to develop the inner work that I did on myself. 4 hours every day for around 2 years. You can calculate the number of hours I put in, you know. And that is why I keep stressing on inner work. And that is why I keep stressing that my patent, nobody has my patent the way I do inner work and the way I have my list. Out of which 50 or 60 sessions you see in the description boxes. They are just a glimpse of the whole process, around 300 sessions, you know. And they are just with me. They are my development and they go only to my clients who get them. They are not like distributed everywhere and are known everywhere, or the methodology is known to other people, you know. So, okay. So, coming on to Ankita Saxena. Hi, Ankita. So the arranged marriage thing goes for Ankita also. So how to prevent an arranged marriage? Like Shraddha said, if you really want to go for that guy or arranged marriage, go for it. That is also your choice. But if you really want to avoid an arranged marriage, they can mentally push you, they can torture you, they can do everything, your family, your relatives or whatever, but they cannot make you sit physically in the mandap, you know. So I would suggest that if you have even little bit of inclination that your twin flame journey is going well or little bit well, then wait for another like maybe 2 years or something and see how it reaches towards the end. And then if nothing works out, still you can always go in for like, you know, an other kind of a marriage or something like that. So telling this to Ankita, but also telling her question. So her question is, how did he realize that yes, there is more to this connection than meets the eye? Because runners are practical in life. So what led him to accept that you are twin flames and he must return back? So what led him to decide when he came back? First of all, he was getting a lot of synchronicities and dreams. He was, most of the times he was on the road after he went from one office to another, you know, in his work life. So on the road, he used to see a lot of signs, And finding my name or my science related to me in the United States is a little bit difficult, you know, because you don't see my name very often in United States. It's a Indian name, you know. So he used to see all those signs and he used to see all those dreams. But what made him return in the human form is missing me. There came a time in those 1 year, 8 months of separation that he started realizing that, you know, there was some spiritual connection, some deep connection. So he also consulted, you know, some friends of his who were in the mental or psychology field or something like that. And he asked them that this is going on with me and, you know, should I just go and marry her and stuff like that. So that was besides the point what he went through in the separation period regarding how he made up his mind. But when he came to me, he told me that he had really missed me. And that is what made him return. And also that he had been, from 2 months, he had been actually visualizing in his mind how it will feel when he actually meets me again after such a long time. And what we will be doing or what he wants to do with me. He was visualizing that, you know, he said from 2 months. So he had already decided 2 or 3 months back. But see, it took him so much time to actually step up to the plate. You know, that is why I keep saying that, you know, take the delays also with a pinch of salt. So thank you. So next question, Himadri Rajpal, she's asking, how is your health now? Himadri, thank you for asking. As I've told you before, I have improved, but still I cannot walk. I cannot, you know, do my household things or help anybody in my family yet. I am pretty weak, you know. All I can do is sit and do some work, you know. So I won't say I'm fully recovered, you know. If I did not have my mainstream profession, work, and if I did not have you guys work, I would be resting all the time. So I hope you understand. So next question is Jane Conti. So they want to know, hello and thank you so much. Hello. Take first of all good care. I mean, there's a spelling mistake or something. I think they're asking me to take good care. I have a similar question, like a person below, about finances. Do you think that it will be all resolved when union comes? Union is not the answer to your finances or other troubles, you know. Union is just another milestone in life. And for all other problems like finances or something else, you have to use the law of attraction to set your alignment or vibration in that way that your finances improve. But yes, with union and with the twin flame journey, the sources or the universe is guiding you towards a profession that will best suit you. So if you take heed of those impulses that are coming to you from above and you choose that kind of a thing or your life purpose, then obviously money will follow your passion, you know. But otherwise, finances, you have to deal in a separate way by the law of attraction using Abraham Hicks principles. You can attract finances, you know. So she's asking about one of my previous channelings where she says that you said that there's a business love and children are involved, or so this will end or has ended. I already told in the channeling that it has ended, you know. So this is kind of, these are the kind of comments which are a waste of time. When I've spoken something and somebody is asking something again, you know, that is why I say be a little considerate, because this is my secondary profession, you know, and I have a lot of other things to do as well. But anyhow, those things where he is, you know, in such kind of a relationship, business relationship, that has recently happened, it has mostly ended for 90% of you. And if it has not ended, it will end in the next 1 month or so. Thank you so much. So Cheryl Thomas, I'm very happy that you're getting well. I appreciate you and all you do. Thank you so much, Cheryl. So going on to the next one, Mosmi Rana. Hi, Gagan. Hi, Mosmi. First, I love you for your divine work. How and when did your twin express or realize that he is your twin, and what was your reaction and feelings that time? So my twin is a person who doesn't really, you know, he is a very charming person and he talks, but he talks, he is kind of, I would say, a very romantic and irrelevant talker. Like when he is in the mood, he would say romantic things and stuff like that. But he would kind of overdo it. You know, sometimes he gives me a lot of compliments. So that is a way of his expressing his love. Like he would say, oh, what nice candles you have put, or what a nice bathrobe, you know, things like that. when it is just a regular bathrobe or something, and you can know that, you know, he's just complimenting for the, sometimes I feel for the sake of it, but he really does it from the depths of his heart. So I think he maybe might have realized it before me, that, you know, there was a spiritual or deep connection. And I went into the research and other part of it, and I kind of took my time. But since we started as a relationship and started as a dating scenario, when he finally expressed, and also when we reunited, he brought a very long stemmed red rose, you know, a single red rose. So that was a very big thing from a person who doesn't really talk much about his feelings and all that, you know. So definitely, yeah, when he expressed himself in various ways and various situations, you know, it was a very nice feeling for me, because that is what the whole scene was all about, dating and relationships, even without the twin flame label. So also I would like to tell you one thing, and I would like to tell everybody one thing. It does not matter whether you know that they are your twin flame or not. If you're finding that deep connection, if you're finding that connection for a lifetime, you don't have to label it, you know. The label is just a label, you know. It is not like you will one day after union, you will sit down to discuss on the dining table that, yeah, you know, I am a twin flame and you are my twin flame and I have this channel and should we do this channel together or should we start helping people together, you know. It just should happen naturally. And it can also be, oh yeah, my name is Gagan, your name is this, and we have this deep connection, let's help people together, you know. Twin flame is just a label, just like soulmates or something like that. And yes, sometimes if you can sit together and say, you know, we are twin flames and all that, you know, you can discuss. But if somebody is uncomfortable or it doesn't really, it is very nice if you can discuss it, but it is not necessary. That is what I'm trying to say. It is not necessary to discuss this in the physical reality. But if both of them already know, you know, they can discuss it also. But yeah, when he expressed it after the union, he brought a rose and it was a very nice feeling. So, and I guess he knew it before me, you know, that we were twin flames. He knew it quite from the very beginning, but still he was more in the practical sense and I was more in the spiritual, more spiritually awakened. So, okay. So, the next question is from Danielle Love. So, they want to know, how did you develop your psychic gifts? So, like I said, my psychic gifts had already developed from 2006, but I was working with different modalities. Like, I used to work more with cards and other stuff, and now I'm a psychic medium and I work directly with the source. And I also work with clouds, with leaves, with trees, you know, with the non-living objects like chairs and tables. Anybody can give me messages now. Earlier, I was working with cards, different decks, you know, and I used to deal with different issues, finances, health, you know, love and everything. Now I just deal with the psychic mediumship gifts, where I can tell you anything from your lost object to your lost husband to your lost anything, you know, and everything related to twin flames and twin flame specific inner work. That is, if there was one thing I would say is my patent, and nobody can do it like me, is my twin flame channel readings. The kind of information that I give you with timelines and stuff, when your marriage is going to happen, what you know, and my patented inner work, nobody else has that. Did it come after or before you met him? It came before also as a spiritual master from 2006, and when I met him in 2013, it intensified a lot in 2014, and now pretty much, you know, even I am amazed with the way my psychic abilities work. What is your relationship with him like now? It is a relationship. It is a relationship status. You know, it is, are you guys together, married? We are together, but we are not married yet. How did you guys meet? I already answered it. We met through a dating website. What was the experience like? It was beautiful. I won't trade it for any other experience ever. So, yeah, this is it, and then we'll go to the next ones later.